Good morning students. Last class we have discussed about 16th group elements. So 16th group elements like oxygen, sulfur, selenium, tellurium and polonium. So already we have discussed about electronic configuration of 16th group and physical properties. Today we are discuss about chemical properties of 16th group elements. So overall the 16th group elements reacts with a number of components like oxygen and hydrogen and halogens. Okay, so now first it is reacts with the hydrogen. Reaction with the hydrogen. So overall oxygen, sulfur, selenium, tellurium, polonium. Okay, oxygen, sulfur, selenium, tellurium, polonium. So these components is these elements are 16th group elements. Suppose for example hydrogen reacts with oxygen to form water molecules. So it is oxygen hydride. So oxygen form H2O water molecules. And sulfur to give H2S, hydrogen sulfide. Next H2SE, selenium to form H2SE, and tellurium to form H2TE, and polonium form H2PO. So overall H2O water molecules, H2S hydrogen sulfide, H2SE selenide, okay, selenide. Next H2TE telluride. So H2PO polonide. Okay, so these are all 16th group hydrides. Okay, so overall oxygen hydride, sulfur hydride, selenium hydride, tellurium hydride or polonium hydride. So overall here water molecules is a liquid, remaining is like gaseous components. So only here water molecules is a liquid, but H2S is a gas. So in water molecules it contain hydrogen bond between oxygen and hydrogen. Okay, so in water molecules between oxygen and hydrogen it contain hydrogen bond. Okay, due to this reason so water molecules contain liquid state and but does not contain hydrogen bonds in H2S. So due to this reason it contain gaseous state. So it is very important. Overall H2O is liquid, H2S is gas. Why? Yes, H2O is liquid but H2S is gas. In water molecules so it's contain hydrogen bond between oxygen and hydrogen molecules, but do not form hydrogen bond in H2S. Due to this reason so water molecules is liquid state and H2S element components is gaseous components. And overall so in H2O and H2S oxygen is a central atom. It is attached with two hydrogen atoms in single bond. So same as the suppose sulfur. So sulfur is a central atom. It is also attached with two hydrogen atoms or suppose selenium or tellurium. So central atom. So each 16th group element attached with two hydrogen atoms. Just like it is a bent molecule or bent structure. Okay. So overall, each atom, each central atom contain two lone pairs. So that two lone pairs is they are indicated with the dot lines. Okay. So overall bent structure, and each compound sp3 hybridization. Okay, H2O what molecules is sp3 hybridization, or H2S is sp3 hybridization. So each molecule contain sp3 hybridization. And next further, just like so water molecules contain 104 degree 28 minutes bond angle. So water molecules contain how much bond angle? 104 degree 28 minutes bond angle. And H2S 92 degrees and 91 degree and 90 degree. Overall from H2O to H2TE, water molecules to telluride, so decrease the bond angle, because just like increase the repulsion. According to Vesper theory, when increase the repulsion, decrease the bond angle. Okay, decrease the bond angle. So overall in water molecule, so oxygen atom contain two lone pairs and two bond pairs. The repulsion is very high between bond pair to bond pair, lone pair to lone pair, and a bond pair to lone pair. Okay, so overall the repulsion is very high. When increase the repulsion, decrease the bond angle. Okay, so overall, so H2O is a dual nature, means acidic nature as well as basic nature. H2S is a acidic nature, and H2SE is also acidic nature. Acidic nature is increased from H2O to H2TE. Okay, acidic nature is increased from water molecules to telluride. It is a reaction with the hydrogen. So overall this group elements reaction with hydrogen to form their hydrides. So that is H2O, H2S, H2SE, H2TE. Okay, so next further, reaction with the oxygen. So overall these elements is reacts with oxygen. So suppose E is sulfur, selenium or tellurium. So these elements is reacts with the oxygen to form two types of oxides, that is the EO2 formula of oxides, and next further EO3 formula of oxides. EO2 formula of oxides is called dioxides. EO3 formula of oxides is called trioxides. So overall these are, suppose for example SO2 sulfur dioxide, or SeO2 selenium dioxide. Suppose example trioxide SO3 sulfur dioxide. So overall sulfur dioxide and sulfur dioxide, these two oxides contain acidic nature. Okay, sulfur dioxide and sulfur trioxide. So these two oxides contain acidic nature. So dioxides contain, just like a dioxide contain linear shape, and trioxides contain So overall trioxides contain planar trigonal shape. Okay, so planar trigonal shape. What is the shape of trioxides? Planar trigonal shape. So overall these are all components, all oxides are good reducing agent. Okay, good reducing agent. So overall SO2 is a good reducing agent. Okay, so listen, these 16th group elements, so like a sulfur, selenium, tellurium, this group elements is reacts with oxygen to form two types of oxides, that is EO2 formula of oxides, dioxides, EO3 formula of oxides, trioxides. Suppose for example SO2 dioxide, SO3 trioxide. So SO2 dioxide contain linear shape, SO3 trioxide contain planar trigonal shape. SO2, SO3, these two oxides contain acidic nature, and overall these oxides good reducing agents. Okay, so it is reacts with the oxygen. Next further reacts with the halogens. So already we know that halogens, so fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine. Fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine are halogens. So in this halogens, very fluorine is reacts with the number of components, number of elements to form number of different types of compounds. So very highly reactive nature fluorine, greater than chlorine, greater than bromine, very highly reactive nature. So fluorine, very low reactive nature iodine. So fluorine is easily react with the 16th group elements. So overall these group elements to formation of three types of oxides, that is EX6 formula of oxides, that is hexahalides, next EX4 formula of oxide halides, that is tetrahalides, and EX2 formula of halides, that is dihalides. Okay, number one hexahalides, number two tetrahalides, number three dihalides. Okay, suppose for example SF6 is the hexahalides, like a sulfur hexafluoride. So EX4 formula of compounds like SF4 sulfur tetrafluoride. Suppose EX2 formula of compound SCl2 sulfur dichloride. Okay, so overall sulfur hexafluoride. So hexahalides contain which shape? Octahedral shape. Okay, hexahalides contain octahedral shape, and tetrahalides contain so square planar shape. Okay, square planar shape. And next further dihalides contain linear shape. Okay, so hexahalides octahedral shape, tetrahalides square planar shape, and dihalides just like a linear shape. Okay, so overall these group elements reacts with the halogens. So mainly fluorine is highly reactive with the all elements compared with remaining all elements. So that is order, reactivity order, mainly fluorine greater than chlorine, greater than bromine, greater than iodine. So these group elements reacts with the halogens to form three types of halides, that is EX6 formula of halide, next EX4 formula of halides, and EX2 formula of halides. Okay, so it is reacts with the halogens. Okay, so next further we have discuss preparation of oxygen and the chemical properties of oxygen. Next, preparation of ozone and chemical properties of ozone. okay.